In the last video, I showed how to create videos from printing on the Prusa MK4S 3D printer using a mobile phone and the Prusa GPIO Hackerboard. A few days after the video was posted, I received a package from AliExpress that relates to this video and whose contents I would like to show you. Before we start, I would like to say a few words. Everything you will see in this video, I bought myself with my own money. Nobody has any influence on the content of the video and nobody pays me for it. If you want to support my work, you can do so by subscribing here on YouTube, on my social media and by sharing my videos. In this video, we will be working with a product which is plugged into a printer motherboard. Improper handling can damage not only this product, but more importantly, your 3D printer. Everything you do is at your own risk. In the last video, I showed the use of this Bluetooth trigger to which I soldered 4 wires. 2 wires for remote button control using Prusa GPIO Hackerboard. 2 wires to power the button using a USB charger. A few days after posting the last video, I received this Bluetooth trigger and this 4-pin 2.5mm jack connector from AliExpress. Links to both products can be found in the description below the video. This Bluetooth trigger has an advantage in having a USB connector already and only one button. This eliminates the need to choose which button to use. Also, there is no risk of damaging this Bluetooth trigger by incorrectly connecting the wires from the USB cable. I ordered this 4-pin 2.5mm jack connector as a replacement for this DuPont connector. In the previous video, I used the DuPont connector to connect the Bluetooth trigger to the Prusa GPIO Hackerboard for the ability to control the button using a 3D printer. In the video, I pointed out the correct orientation of the DuPont connector so that the trigger would not remain in an activated and unusable state for us. This is not the case when using this connector. If you decide to use this Bluetooth trigger with the Prusa GPIO Hackerboard, you may want to follow some instructions on how to modify it. So, let's get to it. Use a sharp object to lift the front cover. After removing the cover, you should see something similar or even the same. This button has 2 pass-through contacts that connect when you press it. Use the metal tweezers to check which 2 contacts need to be connected when the device is on and paired. In order to simulate pressing the button remotely, I needed to solder 2 wires to these contacts. Before that, you need to decide which pin from the open drain section of the Prusa GPIO Hackerboard you want to use. I will stick to the same wiring and configuration as in the previous video. For this particular connector, the colors go in this order. So, I will use the black wire for common ground and the red wire for pin 0. If you don't want to solder the wires directly to the button, you can use the control pins on the back of the circuit board of this trigger. Using metal tweezers, I verified that the button is connected to the common ground pin and the GPIO 7 pin. That's why I soldered a black wire to the common ground pin and a red wire to the GPIO 7 pin for pin 0. You also need to decide where you want to route this cable out of the device. I chose to route the cable out the bottom of the Bluetooth trigger. However, I had to drill the necessary hole in the empty case. While drilling, all the electronics were completely removed from the device. In the end, everything had to be carefully reassembled and tested. The whole assembled device then just needs to be connected to a USB charger to ensure a constant power supply and to the Prusa GPIO Hackerboard. Everything else related to creating videos from printing and configuring Stop Motion Studio and Prusa Slicer I have already shown in the previous video. If you haven't seen that video, go watch it right after you finish watching this video. I discovered another Bluetooth trigger on AliExpress that uses the never USB-C connector instead of the micro USB connector. I did order the Bluetooth trigger, but the entire shipment is delayed. Because of that, I couldn't show you the trigger in this video and I don't plan to make another video about the mobile Bluetooth trigger. If you would still like to know something about this Bluetooth trigger, please let me know in the comments below the video. If you'd be interested in learning how to create the same videos while printing with your DSLR camera, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe.